tased me without any warning, for no reason. I had no idea why.
Tacoma police use force to arrest and handcuff a deaf woman after she called 911 for help. Now, instead of getting an apology, she ended up bloody. She was thrown in jail for nearly 3 days without an interpreter before all charges were eventually dropped. After months of digging, Cairo 7 team investigative reporter Chris Halsney uncovers serious questions about the official police version of what happened.
Some veteran officers tell me responding to a fight call is often chaotic. They have to make split-second decisions to stay safe. But here's the real question. If they make an error in that situation and arrest the victim instead of the alleged assaulter, will they admit it?
And ever since, I haven't been able to stop thinking about it. It's just been stressing me out, wondering what's going to happen next. You
know? When LaShawn White found herself under attack in her own apartment, she turned on her special video-equipped phone.
Right now, this is serious.
And began frantically communicating in sign language to a deaf help relay service.
She's fighting at me, and then she chokes me. She comes right at me.
The words on this 911 call are LaShawn's, but the voice is that of a certified ASL interpreter speaking to Tacoma Police Dispatch. Internal police records show Officer Ryan Kuskovich and his partner were outside LaShawn's apartment complex in less than 6 minutes. Dispatch texted them along the way. Person doing the hitting is a Sophia. Victim is LaShawn White. According to dispatch officer communication logs, the patrolmen were repeatedly provided information that the victim could not hear a thing.
I'm deaf. I can't hear if they're out front knocking or whatever. I can't. No, are they going to the front or the back? Where are the police at?
The police want her to go outside the front door.
Oh, they're here? Okay, I'm on my way to meet them. I'm going right now.
LaShawn showed our cameras her route straight out of her basement apartment door, up one flight of stairs, and through the double glass doors leading to the street. A 30-second trip. To LaShawn, what happened next defies common sense, especially for a woman with no criminal record, no arrests, and just one minor traffic violation ever. Within seconds of running outside to meet police, Officer Kuskovich pulls out his taser and fires a two-barbed electric wire into LaShawn's ribs and stomach.
You know, all I'm doing is waving my hand in the air, and then the next thing I know, I'm on the ground. And then I'm being, you know, handcuffed. It was almost like I blacked out, I think, because then I was so dizzy and disoriented.
Witnesses say LaShawn began bleeding heavily from her knuckles and that her face hit the pavement after the taser jolt. Pictures acquired by Team 7 investigators also show injuries to her cheek, chin, ribs, and arms.
Yes, right there. Behind.
Worse yet, to her, was the incredible confusion that came with suddenly being in handcuffs, under arrest, and without the ability to communicate with the Tacoma officers, neither who knew any sign language.
And the next thing I know, they took me into jail. And they told me, please stand up, you're going to jail. I said, what? What have I done? I couldn't figure it out. I had no idea what was going on.
Cairo Team 7 investigators canvassed the area near the taser incident for witnesses. Margaret Sims's apartment is right over the spot. She says it was around 11:30 at night and dark when she heard LaShawn screaming in pain and ran to the balcony.
I hollered down and I said, she's deaf and can't speak.
Sims spoke with the officers while LaShawn was still in handcuffs. She says they admitted there was a misunderstanding.
They had faced her because he thought she was coming at him. Well, what she was doing was running to him, but he said stop, but he didn't put his hand up. He just said stop. And she couldn't understand that.
I said, she's deaf. She couldn't even hear you.
Another apartment tenant, Geraldine Warren, says she heard the whole commotion too.
When I got outside the door, he was standing there. I said, aren't you supposed to say, how, like that?
That's exactly what both officers told their superiors after the fact. Kuskovich wrote, I yelled for White to stop and held my right hand up to signal for White to stop. White ignored my commands. He added, White was making a loud grunting noise, had a piercing stare in her eyes, and had a clenched right fist in the air. Using this statement as proof, Tacoma police hit LaShawn with two criminal charges, simple assault and obstruction of a law enforcement officer. They then carted her off to jail.
Why would she run at the police in an assaulting manner?
We asked Cairo TV's police conduct consultant and former Bellevue police chief Don Van Blaricom to review conflicting accounts of LaShawn's arrest.
A taser is a very useful device under the circumstances that necessitate its use. But it's too easy to use and it's frequently used too quickly, and this looks to me like one of those cases.
State law on this topic isn't murky at all. It says law enforcement agencies conducting an investigation shall appoint and pay for a qualified interpreter throughout the investigation. That simply did not occur for LaShawn White.
Well, the story is complex, and the officers at the scene clearly had a different point of view. We have tried to get their explanation for 6 weeks. We've even talked to Tacoma police on the phone, but they would not respond to the allegations. We've also sent them emails and left several messages. If Tacoma police want to explain their side of the story, we will put their explanation on Cairo 7.